Let's dive right in. Today we're talking about the new Remote User Interface, or UI, that's part of the CineLife Plus version 2.0.0 software release. The Remote UI is incredibly helpful. You can use it to perform setup, adjust settings, and perform configuration, and more. So how do you access it? Here are two ways. The first is by using the touch panel controller, an LCD touchscreen that connects to the projector's card cage. We can see it here on screen now. Please note that the touch panel controller is an optional accessory for most CineLife Plus projectors. The second way to access the remote UI is to connect a laptop to your projector via an Ethernet cable and then type in the projector's IP address in a web browser. You'll find instructions on how to do this in document 020-103443-XX. Later in this video, we'll show you how to find the instructions on the Christie website. But before we introduce the new remote UI, let's quickly review the one that's part of the CineLife Plus software package 1.8.4. Here we can see the standard UI that's been used on all CineLife Plus projectors since launch. This means that the UI looks like this on every CineLife Plus projector with a software package between 1.0.0 and 1.8.4. You'll see this screen after power is applied to the projector and it's in standby mode. We recommend logging into your account to access the main menu, where you'll see a few selectable options. If you click Channel Setup, you'll see a long list of possible configurations for each channel. Click About to see the details of your projector, including the software package version, model type, serial number, etc. When you click on Service Menu, you'll see a list of options. Click Preferences and you can set or adjust many different features. Another selection is Language. Click that to change the language you see on your user interface. Please note that in this video, we connect it to the projector using a laptop and Ethernet cable. This projector's IP address is 192.168.206.110. Note that this is the default IP address of this projector. Your projector may have a different IP address. Now that we're familiar with the UI in version 1.8.4 and below, let's first show you how to find and download version 2.0.0 from the Christie website. If we visit the Christie website while we're logged in, we can find the latest and greatest CineLife Plus projector software, along with the software release notes. First, you need to ensure that you are logged in on our website at the top right corner of the screen. If you don't have an account, you must register there first. After you log in, navigate to Cinema Solutions. From there, you'll see all the different cinema projectors. Click on CineLife Plus Series. Note that this video and the new UI we're talking about is only available on these models. CineLife Plus projectors are Christie Series 4 projectors. Version 2.0.0 software applies to any projector that has a 4 as the second number in the cinema model name. For example, the projectors on this page are CP2415RGB, CP2420RGB, etc. After you select your projector, you can view Downloads. This is where you'll find all applicable downloads. In the Software Downloads section, you'll see CineLife Plus software release notes for version 2.0.0.72 or above, and CineLife Plus main software version 2.0.0.72 or above. Please download both files. We recommend reading the software release notes. Here's an example of the software release notes. Scroll down to review important information such as affected products, purpose of release, known issues, and upgrading the projector software instructions. We highly recommend that you read all of this material before performing the upgrade. You'll find more helpful information on the website in the technical bulletin associated with this software release here. Open the document and you'll see an explanation of some new key features of the new remote UI that's part of the CineLife Plus version 2.0.0 release. After you read the software release notes and the technical bulletin, you're ready to perform the upgrade to version 2.0.0 on your projector. Once the upgrade's complete, you'll have the new CineLife Plus Remote UI. If you don't have an optional touch panel controller and you need instructions on how to connect your laptop to the projector to access the UI, go to the Christie website. You'll find this document under Instruction Sheets. Next, we'll assume that you downloaded version 2.0.0 or above from the Christie website and successfully upgraded your projector. If you did this correctly, you'll see a new screen immediately upon boot up. You should see this image when you boot up while connected to the projector. Just like the previous UI, you'll need to log in. You'll log in to the user interface using your regular account login and password. You should now see the new landing page. This will bring us to the home page. If you ever want to go back to this window, just click on the home button. If we click on the three lines beside the home button, we can access the main menu. Once we see the main menu, we'll notice that it has the exact same options as the previous version. Here we can see a quick screenshot of the previous UI as a reference to show that we have the same main menu selections. Let's explore. If we click Channel Setup, we'll see everything we'd expect, but also some new tabs: Light, Image, and Color. These new tabs are helpful since they categorize all channel settings. Click Image Settings and we'll see the same options as in the previous UI. We could continue clicking on more main menu features, but they're all identical to the previous UI, with the exception of a few enhancements. Now let's explore some of the newer features. At the top right of the screen, we can see our account login. In this example, we've logged in with the service account. Besides service, we can click Status to see if any warnings or alarms are present. Next to Status, we see the Logout button. For our video, we won't show that option. Beside Logout, we see a picture of our computer with a network cable, showing that we have a network connection to the projector. Next to Logout, we'll see a picture of two active users. This is because two active users are connected to this projector. If more users connect to the projector, this number will increase. Multiple users can perform edits on the exact same page via a different connection, and the most recent change that's submitted will be saved to the projector. Next, we have date and time. After this, we have a search bar. You can search for one word or multiple words, and it will show you all related results. If we type fan, we can see three related options. If we're interested in fan speeds, for example, we can click on that, and it will bring up the status page to show all fan speeds. This projector is currently on standby. As a result, most fan speeds are off at 0 RPM. Next, let's type in ILS. Now we can see all related results. If we click ILS File Setup, it'll bring us into the ILS File Setup page. This is the same as going to Menu, Image Settings, and then ILS File Setup. Next, let's go back to the homepage by clicking the house on the top left corner of the screen. We should now see three different tabs in the center: Upcoming Events, Status, and Alarms. By default, we'll see Status. From the Status screen, we can click any of the green icons for in-depth information related to that icon. For example, if we click on the thermometer labeled Temperature, we'll go directly to the temperature statuses. Next, we can click on Fans. When doing this, we can see all of the projector fan speeds. If we click on the Upcoming Events tab on the homepage, we can see any upcoming events that have been scheduled. Note, this will look similar to the previous UI homepage. We can see a picture for reference here, highlighting the previous UI. The third tab on the homepage is Alarms. The Alarms page is really a dashboard that shows all potential alarms on the system. This is very similar to the Status page, but has a dashboard format. In the bottom right corner, we have Languages. If you'd like to change the language, you can do it here and your UI will display that language. We hope this brief tour of the new Remote UI has been helpful for you. Visit Christie University for more helpful videos like this one.